What's up there, guys? This is Dibaleni Football Channel, Kaizer Chiefs Football Channel. Football from the fans' perspective. Welcome back. Welcome to our new video. We're doing a preview. Kaizer Chiefs versus TTM. It's a game that is playing tomorrow, 19th of January. Kickoff is at 5 o'clock. Yeah. This is the first, I think this is the fifth game of Kaizer Chiefs in just 14 days. So it's a very congested one. It's a very congested one. It means we are playing a game in each and every 3 days. It's a very congested fixture. And there are signs that it's taking its toll in the players. And the game against Maritzburg, Enes Middendorp did highlight in a post-match interview that he knew that Kaizer Chiefs is from Angola and they've been traveling. So, you know, fitness levels and in terms of fatigue is going to show in the second half. And it did show. Maritzburg took advantage of it. Then we had to dust ourselves, go play against AmaZulu. AmaZulu couldn't take advantage of it. We won against AmaZulu. And then won against Cape Town City. But against Cape Town City, did show that there are signs of fatigue. And the manager did, you know, as well, pointed out, the coach, that the boys are getting, you know, tired. And they are not machines. These are players. These are human beings. They're not machines. They're going to get tired. So they need to rest. They need to rest. But to me, it was just a two-way, you know, it was not a one-way to go about it. The fixture, congested fixtures, to me, yes, it's important for players to rest, but it was an issue of saying Kaizer Chiefs has to, you know, get back into winning ways. We need to stand up as soon as possible. And the congested fixture, the games after each and every 3 days are going to help us. And they did help us. They did help us. We were able to fix our mistakes as soon as possible, always to learn from the positives and the negatives, and, you know, take everything to the next game. And that is what is important right now, is that we need to use this congested fixture. Yes, positively. We need to be able to use it positively, because unfortunately, there's no way to go about it. We cannot cancel the games. We cannot, you know, skip the games. It's just not possible. We need to play the games, and we need to take advantage of that fact. I hope the guys are going to take advantage of this one. Yes, if you are new in the channel, I would like to encourage you to subscribe, to turn on the notification button, and let us have the conversation in the comment section. This is a Kaizer Chiefs Football Channel, but it's PSL football. If you're a PSL fan, if you're a Kaizer Chiefs fan, if you're not a Pirates fan, I would like to encourage you to subscribe, to share the videos as well. Let us have a conversation in the comment section. Yeah. So, yeah, we're playing a home game. It's a very interesting one. It's going to be a very tricky game, because Kaizer Chiefs has not won a game at home. This season, we have not won a game at home. We won in Eastern Cape against Chippa. One in KZN against AmaZulu, one in Western Cape against Cape Town City. We have not won a game at home. It has been draws and losses, and we need to rectify that. If we are going to compete anywhere, if we are going to compete for any cup in the league, because we're still in it, of course, we need to win games at home. We need to win games at home. It's not negotiable. If you lose games at home, You can't sustain any competition with winning away games. And the second half of the season is very close. So we need to be ready. We need to collect points as soon as possible. One thing that I like about this game, approaching this game, is that there's a positive mentality. With us as fans, of course, we have very positive mentality. And then there's positive mentality in the camp. It's been very visible. The comments made by Samir Nogovic and the comments made by Akum as well, Antonio Akum as well. He's been featuring in the games. He's been there. He's been trying to fight. There are improvements that we see from him. So he made positive comments. This is what he said about Kaizer Chiefs and the mentality. He says, winning two games in a row is a moral booster. We can continue from where we left off for the next game against TTM. If we can approach the next game in the same way we approached the last two games, I believe that we can get the maximum points we need. Yeah. So that is it. That is it from me. And that's how I read the mentality of the team and the mentality of Kaizer Chiefs, you know, family entirely. That there is a positive mentality, and we need to take this mentality towards the game against TTM. TTM, it's not an easy one. It's not an easy one to me. It's a must-win game for Kaizer Chiefs. It's a must-win game for Kaizer Chiefs. That's another thing that we need to mention. Because we need to get into the top 8, and we need to start competing for that spot up there. I'm not making a mistake when I'm saying we need to compete for the spot up there. And when I'm saying we're still in a race for each and every competition, it's not a mistake. It's not a mistake, that one. So yeah, if we win this game, we're going to be number 7. We're just going to be 2 points above Stellenbosch that we're playing in 3 games, in 3 days after the TTM game. So yeah, if we win now, give us an advantage against it, against Stellenbosch. Push and 14 points. I think it's going to take us to 14 points, and just the team above us is 16 points, Cape Town City. So we'll be close to position number 4 if we win the next two games, CTM game and Stellenbosch game. And for me, there's no other way to go about it. It's a win game. There's no draw. There's no loss. We need to win. We need to win this one. TDM is number 15 in the league. Number 15 in the league, and they have only one win since the beginning of this season. I think they won against Baroka and couldn't win against Baroka. So TDM is not a small. To me, as much as the new team, they are still trying to find their feet in PSL and to combine the team. It's not a small team. It's not an easy one. It's not going to be an easy one. They won against Baroka. They drew against AmaZulu, Leopards, Cape Town City. So it's not a weak team. Not a weak team. And there's PTM has experienced players. They have experienced players. There's Ndengane there. I think there's Mulongane from Kaizer Chiefs. They have Mkhakholo Dingele, Rahale, Tim from Maritzburg. Ndondlo, this boy called Ndondlo is a very good player. Lerato, I think Lerato Lamura is also in that team as well. So it's not a small team. There's players that have well much experience. And then position number 15 is not a good position. Remember when position number 13 we had to win the games. So they have to win these games as well. They need to negotiate points. Even if it's a draw, even if it's a win, they need to negotiate points. They need to get out of that position. And for sure they will be looking to win against Kaizer Chiefs. So yeah, and we don't have a good record. We just drew against, you know, Black Leopards, and the teams, you know, below us, we have not performed well against Maritzburg as well. Didn't win. So we're building. It's a team that is in progress. Kaizer Chiefs is a team that is in progress, and we should not go to TTM thinking we have won the game. That would be very stupid. That would be very foolish of us. They lost against the Arrows. They lost against what is this team? Orlando Pirates. But they lost against big teams. They lost against teams that are very strong right now, that have momentum right now. So you cannot blame them. Cannot entirely blame them. And the only problem with TTM right now that I think is gonna give us an advantage, is good for us, but it's bad for football. Is the fact that they have issues with their players. They're not paying players. There are scandals. The scandals around player payments. I think recently, Mkhakholo Dingele, Lerato Lamola, and others have been on strike. They couldn't play the game against Orlando Pirates because of the payments. And Augustin Mulenga had to leave. I think Augustin signed for Cape Town City right now because of issues of professionalism with that team. To think of it, it's you know, they sold Vids that had 99 years in PSL and shared history with PSL, with the PSL, for TTM, and now, you know, PSL is, you know, it's a very bad image for us. It's a very bad image for football. To understand where PSL is coming from and professionalism and the fact that the standard of football in South Africa has to be up there. So yeah, it's bad image for football in South Africa, but it's good for Kaizer Chiefs. Good. I hope that Ngele and the others won't be there, because Ngele is also, you know, last game against Ngele, he was playing for Black Leopards, and he scored a free kick, if I'm not mistaken, against us. It was a very bad one. We lost a league because of him. So I'm hoping he's going to be out, but it's good for us, bad for football. So the lineup of Kaizer Chiefs tomorrow, for me, I think the coach should keep the lineup the same. I understand if there are changes because of fatigue, because of the congestion of games and all that. But for me, we need to keep the players the same. We need to keep the same center back Akume and Ramashlam Pashela, right back, same Ngezana, left back Zulu, midfield Kadoso should be kept as well. Front of him, Ngobo and Bakas should continue. And then the striking force of Happy Mashiane on the left. On the right, Zuma, Mshuluz, and then Kokota Piano as a striker. So yeah, I think we should keep the same momentum, because it's important for players to build in terms of confidence. And right now we need to find ourselves. Kaizer Chiefs needs to find the lineup. We need to find ourselves. So there's no any other way to go about it. I think we should keep the lineup as it is. Manyama is back. We don't want to remove players and start, you know, lowering their confidence. Bacchus played very well. Contributed the first goal against Cape Town City. The second goal contributed. He needs to start. We don't have to drop him. There's no any other way to go about it in terms of no. According to me, no, he has to start in each and every game. So, yeah, Manyama on the bench and other players on the bench, I wouldn't mind. Castro on the bench, I wouldn't mind as well. And then the next thing is that the young players in Kaizer Chiefs, we need to see more of them. And I'm very grateful for how Kevin Hunt has kept the team and how he's been introducing these guys. I'm very happy. It's very much impressive. The only concern I have is Ntjangase, because I heard the rumors that Ntjangase might, Kaizer Chiefs is trying to sign him again to extend his contract. The question is, the guy has been there in Kaizer Chiefs for a very long time. He's not been favorite of each and every coach. Kampela was there, didn't play him. Solinas didn't play him. Middendorp didn't play him. So right now he's not playing. New guys have come in. Even Ngobe has passed him there. He's been there and he's not getting game time. I just don't know. I think there's talent that is being wasted. If Kaizer Chiefs is going to sign him, then we better have a plan around him. Hunt better have a plan about him and around him, because we can't keep a player that is so good, we know of his talent, keep him in the bench for, I don't know, it's 27 years, 26, 27 years right now. He needs to be in the peak of his career. So yeah, that is it from me. The scoreline, I don't want to predict a scoreline. The games are very unpredictable right now. And I don't want to mislead people. People of Bedway and Hollywood's Bet, they must do their job. They know how to predict line scores and all that. But for me, Kaizer Chiefs win. And hopefully we get our strikers to score. And we get the players that scored in the previous game, we get them to be involved in the goal scoring, you know, contribution right now. The most important thing is keeping a clean sheet. That's the same thing, very same thing that I keep on emphasizing. We need to keep a clean sheet. The defense of Kaizer Chiefs has to improve. So I'm expecting improvements in the defense. That's why I want the coach to keep them, because some of the problems is this thing of chop and change. The last thing that is very much important is consistency. First half and second half, there need not to be too much difference between the two halves. The coach has to improve on that. Otherwise, for Kaizer Chiefs, that is it from me. Dibalane Football Channel, Kaizer Chiefs Football Channel. Football from the fans' perspective, you know what it is. Love and peace.